Hello, welcome to the session on Introduction to Wireless Communication. This is Dayanand Patil, faculty member of Computer Science Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. At the end of this session, students will be acquainted with the wireless communication network and generation of wireless communication. What is wireless communication? Today, we are very familiar with wireless communication because it may be very difficult to move without wireless communication in today's life. The wireless communication is transmitting or receiving voice and data using electromagnetic waves in open space. There will be no any physical connection between the two stations. This information from sender to receiver is carried over a well-defined channel that each channel will be having a fixed frequency bandwidth and capacity. The available spectrum is divided into different channels. These different channels can be used to transmit information in parallel and independently. Usually we'll call it as multiplexing. We will see multiplexing in further videos. The different types of wireless communications are FM radio, TV broadcast, GSM phones, satellite communication, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, Li-Fi, wireless MAN, etc. These wireless communication will be having typical frequencies. Examples, TV broadcast will be having a typical frequency of 200 MHz, and Wi-Fi, Bluetooth will be having a 2.4 GHz. It's that each of these wireless communication will be having that typical frequencies. The advantages and disadvantages of the wireless communication. Working professional can work and access internet anywhere and anytime without carrying a wire or cables wherever they go. We have seen in today's life. So it is very, wireless communication is very helpful for the professional peoples. The industrial people can do the work from home and some people can carry the mobile for email sending, some report sending, and they can perform some other task also. And the main advantage of wireless communication is it is a good solution in an area where cables are impossible to install. Where the cables cannot be impossible to install, the wireless communication is only the solution. And wireless networks are cheaper to install and maintain. These are the advantages of the wireless communication. The disadvantages, wireless communication is influenced by physical obstruction, climate condition, interference from other wireless devices. That is, the climate condition and interference from other wireless devices are the main problem for the wireless communication, and the hackers can easily hack the data on a wireless communication. That is, the securities that security vulnerability is there in a wireless communication. Mobile communication generations, that the mobile communication generations are up till today, there are four. That four generation is present in today's, and the fifth generation is expected next. We'll start from the 1G, that is 1G stands for the first generation. That first generation is introduced in the US in early 1980s. The duration between 1980s to 1990 is considered as the first generation era. In the first generation, that analog signals were used to transmit the data. It was exclusively designed only for the voice communication. In the first generation, at that point of time, the only voice was transferred. There was no text data were transferred like the text message, or there was no any videos were transferred. There was only voice was transferred for the communication. And some characteristics of the first generation are the speed up to 2.4 kbps and poor voice quality compared with the next generation 2G, 3G and 4G. Large phones with a limited battery life, that those who have seen the mobile phones in the duration between the 1980s to 1990, that phones were very big in size and the battery life was not much compared with the today's generation. And the no data security, that data security was less compared with the 2G and 3G, 4G generation. Second generation. The second generation launched in Finland in 1991. In second generation, digital signals were used to transmit the data. In the first generation, only 5 signals were transmitted. In the second generation, the digital signals were used to transmit the data. And GSM technology was used. The GSM stands for Global System for Mobile Communication. In the second generation, first time GSM protocol is used. Some other characteristics of 2G communication are the speed is achieved up to 64 kbps. It was 2.4 kbps in a 1G. It is achieved to the 64 kbps in second generation, and text and multimedia messaging was possible in a 2G. That only voice was transferred in a 1G, but in 2G that multimedia message were possible and text message were transferred, and better voice quality than the 1G. That voice quality is improved in a 2G, and the 2G with GPRS is also referred as 2.5G. This is a step ahead from a 2G. At that point of time, the GPRS is used for the better experience of internet browsing. The GPRS stands for General Packet Radio Service. Third generation. The third generation of mobile telephony begin in 2000. The duration between 2000 to 2010 is considered as the third generation era. In the third generation era, that CDMA technology is used. The CDMA stands for co-division multiplexing, multiple access. That many other multiple access technologies are used in a 3G. We will see those multiple access technologies in a further videos. Some characteristics of 3G communication are the speed is achieved in terms of Mbps. Now we can imagine in first generation it was 2.4 kbps. But in third generation, it is achieved in terms of Mbps, that is 2 Mbps. And the other features like 3D gaming is supported in 3G. And high speed web browsing compared with the second generation. And enables a wide variety of applications such as web browsing, email, video calling, online TV, online games, etc. That email sending and web browsing were supported in 2G also. But in third generation, that speed is achieved up to 2 Mbps, and so this enables the online TV, online games, etc. And the one down point we can consider in a 3G, that is expensive mobile phones, high infrastructure cost like licensing fees and mobile towers, because Android mobiles were started in a third generation, so we can consider this as the down point in a 3G. Now we'll come to the 4G. This is think and write. We have discussed the first generation, second generation and third generation. In these three generations, we have listed out some characteristics and technologies used in those technologies. When we'll come to the fourth generation, today we are in a fourth generation. We are using the 4G mobiles. We have seen the technologies used and the characteristics of 4G. So now you can pause the video and you can think and write for the question. The question is list out technologies and characteristics in 4G. Now pause the video and write the answer. The answer is that the fourth generation of mobile telephony began in 2011. The duration between 2011 to 2020 is considered as the fourth generation era. And the different technologies like Wi-Fi, LTE is used. The LTE stands for long term evolution. This delivers the fastest connection for mobile internet connection. This will give the better experience for the mobile internet connection. And the other technology like IP telephony, speed is achieved in Gbps, that is up to 1 Gbps. Cloud computing, high definition mobile TVs, online TVs are used in third generation also. That high definition mobile TV with a better experience is used in a 4G. And you can list out the more characteristics and technologies. The list will go on. So these are the some points related to the 4G technology. This is the comparison table with different generations, 1G, 2G, 3G and 4G. So that 5G is expected between the duration 2020 to 2030 with different parameters in a future. But these four, 1G, 2G, 3G and 4G is up to the today's generation, that is between 2010 to 2020. These are the comparison table. These are the references I have used. Thank you.